My name is Ivan Rusyn. I'm a professor of environmental sciences and engineering at the University of North Carolina, Chapel Hill. My project within the Superfund program is investigating the inter-individual differences in metabolism of trichloroethylene. Trichloroethylene is an important chemical because it's been produced in high volumes, used in a lot of chemical synthesis for more complex chemicals. In addition, it's a really good solvent, so it's used quite frequently in degreasing operations, both in the industry and also in dry cleaning. Trichloroethylene is an environmental contaminant. A lot of people get exposed. There is most evidence for kidney cancer in people for exposure with trichloroethylene. The federal agency that regulates TC and related chemicals is Environmental Protection Agency. Our particular project is working to get data that will help EPA to do a better job with risk assessment because we're addressing the gaps in knowledge that still remain. In the lab, we would have frozen liver, kidney tissues, or processed blood. And then we are interested in how TC gets metabolized, so we can measure metabolite concentrations and then compare those to human samples. My lab has been working very hard to try to establish methodology to be able to measure precisely the amounts of kidney toxic metabolites of trichloroethylene. Another important part of our research is trying to understand whether there are differences between individuals that have been exposed to the same dose of trichloroethylene, but that may form different amounts of TC metabolites. We really need to have better science for regulatory decision making, so the type of data that we're trying to collect will potentially make a reassessment of TC for its potential human hazard much more based on science rather than some assumptions. We're talking about chemicals that are out in the environment, and we can't really remove them from the environment completely. The purpose of this research is not to prove that this particular chemical or other particular chemical is dangerous and thus should be banned. We really need to understand what exposures may be potentially safe, if any.